told her we should.
Good morning. My goodness. Good morning.
Oh, there it is.
Well, yeah. Brian's like, not in here. Brian's
come on. Here you guys, it has been a beautiful weekend. Everybody should be like super pumped, super happy, super sunshiny. And we are happy that you have come to worship with us. We're going to worship the sun today. Would you please stand to sing with us?
Well, good morning. Takes a second, come on, and the lights come on, and they're not quite ready yet. And then the little battery comes on, and you're like, okay, you can talk. Hello, welcome to Creve Coeur Christian Church. We are glad that you are here to worship with us. This is not normally my month to be able to do announcements, and I'm not doing all of them. But there's a couple announcements that we would like you guys to be aware of, and we've been asked that maybe the leadership would be side to be able to announce these. So I have volunteered. I don't know if that's foolishly or willingly, you know, but that's okay. We have been purging, is what we're calling it. We're getting rid of some things that have been in the church that are not used for frequently used. So we're going to be getting rid of some stuff, decluttering some things. So it's been announced about 3 weeks ago, but we want to continually keep you guys informed of what's going on. We are going to be remodeling some things in the church, and we need to make some space for some things. And some things we're just like, we're not even sure why we have that. So we're going to be getting rid of some things. This past Wednesday night, we started with the fellowship hall with some closets and cabinets. And just get rid of stuff that has been collected over years. Tables have been set up in the fellowship hall. So we have some things, what we're not just pitching it at this moment. And we have some things that we have not seen much use of over a while. And so we have grabbed it and we're setting it on. There's multiple tables in the fellowship hall by the group of tables and chairs we're keeping, but there's some tables set up with some things that are on there that we are not going to be using. So if you have donated that in the past or would have use of that at your house, feel free to take it. Because if it's not taken, we're going to be getting rid of it. So that stuff over there is for free for you, and there will be multiple things. So each week, come back and check to see, because we are planning on each Wednesday having sections of the church that we're just making some more space and being able to be organized and find things quickly, because I've been on the receiving end of searching and searching and searching and going, I don't know where this is at. And then, you know, we eventually find it. But we want to make that a little bit more easier for all of us, and then just not to have every inch packed with things. So if you're available for help, we're doing every Wednesday starting at 5. I know it was announced for like 5 to 8:30. We were not here till 8:30 last Wednesday. But starting at 5, and if you can't make it the whole time, that's okay. But if you're willing and able to help, we would appreciate it. But please check out to make sure that you're not left in the dark of something that maybe you are wanting, or and go ahead and take that, and we will be just moving forward. We want to keep you informed. It's in our bulletins. It's in our callers. We're going to be announcing it. And we have two pianos over there that we don't want. They've just sat there. If you're interested in pianos, there's two of them, feel free to take it, but you will need to provide people and a truck, and those by October 1st. So October 1st, after that, we're planning on letting out to like public. We want the church to have first go at for these things, and then we'll see with the public, and then we're gonna bring in some dumpsters and just get rid of some things. So there's my first announcement. My second announcement is with the Fall Fun Fest. Unfortunately, we're going to have to cancel the Fall Fun Fest, and I will explain why, but we are going to have a movie night on September 29th over in the field by the park over here, and so it's just a day before. We're going to have a 30-foot screen come, and we're going to have a projector, we're going to have a movie, we're going to have popcorn, we have sign-up sheets, so that way we can have enough popcorn, but it's open to the public, so bring friends, family, whoever. But the reason why we've had to cancel the Fall Fun Fest is because our insurance company that we'd had just decided that they're no longer going to insure any church. So with that, we've had to find a new insurance. Our insurance agent is the same, and he's been working with us to find an insurance on a quick notice. And in doing so, we're not in the insurance we would like to be right now, but we needed insurance. And with this insurance company, it will blow our budget just to get an insurance thing for one day pass for a bouncy houses. So unfortunately, we can't, you know, just throw out the money to it, because we won't have any budget to do anything else. So that's why we have canceled the Fall Fun Fest. We plan on having that again next year, but at this moment we won't this year, but we plan on we're having a movie September 29th. We don't know what we're watching yet. We're working on the copyright laws to be able to view it publicly. So that will be put out on Facebook and announced here once we know what we are watching. Thank you for your time, and Miss Gretchen's gonna take the rest of the things for us on this way.
Okay. Other family business that you need to know about. The food bank will be handing out flyers at Kroger next Saturday from 1 to 2. And like all tasks, many hands make light work. So if you can spare an hour, meet down at the Kroger at East Peoria to hand out flyers. Yes, sir. Oh, I stand corrected. It's the Morton Kroger. So you can stop and have Monocles afterwards or Pizza Ranch or something. Okay. Morton Kroger, my bad. Students who are part of C4, you will continue to meet on Sundays, but we're switching your time. You're going to be from 2 to 4 Sunday afternoons, every Sunday starting next week. No C4 tonight, starting next Sunday afternoon, 2 to 4 every Sunday. Okay, and that allows the adult leaders to be able to participate in their small groups. I think that was it. Okay, so call to worship. Psalm 111. Hallelujah. I praise the Lord with all my heart in the company and congregation of the upright. Great are the works of the Lord, searched out by all who delight in them. Glorious and majestic is his work, and his righteousness endures forever. He made his wonders memorable. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion. He gives food to those who fear him. He remembers his covenant forever. He shows his people his powerful deeds, giving them the heritage of the nations. The works of his hands are truth and justice. All his precepts are trustworthy. They are upheld forever and ever, made in truth and uprightness. He has sent redemption to his people. He has ordained his covenant forever. Holy and awesome is his name. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. It's the beginning of wisdom. All who follow his precepts have good understanding. His praise endures forever. If you'll stand, I'm going to pass the microphone to Mr. Crook, and he'll lead us in prayer.
Our Lord and God and Heavenly Father, I'm so glad to be here again. I don't know how much I miss this church when sickness comes and I can't quite make it. But I'm here and to worship with the body of Christ and to be with these brothers and sisters in Christ right here. I thank you, and I thank you for your awesome presence. I pray for the body that we would be reaching out to those who need to know you, for your love and your care and your presence in their life. I thank you for the wonderful sermons of Bill and the wonderful singing and the wonderful time we have together as the body of Christ. Thank you, Jesus, once again, for your love, for your care, and your presence in the life of me and the rest of this congregation. For it is in Jesus' precious name that I pray. Amen.
We know is not in fear. There is in the book of Genesis, chapter 20. So Abimelech got up early in the morning and called all his servants and told all these things in their presence, and the people were greatly frightened. And then Abimelech called Abraham and said to him, "What have you done to us? And how have I sinned against you that you have brought on me and on my kingdom a great sin? You have done to me things that ought not to be done."
Remember, Well, good morning. Romans 3, 23 to 26 states, "For everyone has sinned, we all fall short of God's glorious standard. Yet God, with undeserved kindness, declares that we are righteous. He did this through Christ Jesus when he freed us from the penalty for our sins. For God presented Jesus as a sacrifice for sin. People are made right with God when they believe that Jesus sacrificed his life, shedding his blood. This sacrifice shows that God was being fair when he held back and did not punish those who sinned in times past. For he was looking ahead and including them in what he would do in this present time. God did this to demonstrate his righteousness, for he himself is fair and just, and he declares sinners to be right in his sight when they believe in Jesus." Well, I got another song, and I planned to use a song the praise team had 2 or 3 weeks ago, and I decided I was going to use it later because I was in the car again listening to the message, and I heard a song that, again, I think it was new to me, but then I find out it's about a year old, but I felt like it had a wonderful and appropriate message for communion. It's called "Jesus Does." It's by We the Kingdom.
Who tells the sun to rise every morning, colors the sky with the shades of his glory, makes us with mercy and love, Jesus does. Who holds the orphan, comforts the widow, cries for injustice, feels every sorrow, carries the pain of his children, Jesus does. Heart of a sinner, showers his grace over all our mistakes, washes us clean with his blood, Jesus does. I believe that he does. Who sings a song of sweet forgiveness? Who stole the key to hell and the grave?
And if the servers want to start coming forward, we'll all unite in sharing the emblems of the Lord's Supper here in a couple of minutes. I can't really add a whole lot to that song because Jesus does show compassion, love, and mercy. Jesus does understand our hearts as sinners. Jesus does shower grace over all our mistakes, and Jesus does wash us clean with his blood. Jesus is our best friend. He is faithful, and he will rescue our soul because that's what Jesus does. Just ask, please reflect on what Jesus does as we prepare to unite here in the sharing of the emblems. Would you pray with me, please? Dear God, we just thank you so much for showing us your unconditional love and forgiveness, and we thank you so much for sending your son, Jesus, and we thank Jesus for his compassion, mercy, and blood that he lovingly sacrificed on the cross for our sins. Please help us to love each other and help us to focus on Jesus' love and his grace, and help us to be mindful of his sacrifice on the cross as we partake of these emblems that represent Christ's broken body and his blood that he shed for our sins. Glory to his name, and we give you all the praise and glory, and it's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Thank you.
At this time, the kids are dismissed to Kid City and all those who are helping with that.